Okay, so you run a nonprofit organization. Your organization is growing. More volunteers, more donors, more projects, more everything. That's great, but when things start to grow, it becomes overwhelming, and it's hard to keep track of everything. You know you need some more powerful software, but you're not much of a computer whiz. And all the cloud technology out there seems like it's made for big companies, not nonprofit organizations. Wouldn't it be great if someone could harness all this powerful cloud technology and use it for good? Introducing Cloud for Good, the team of cloud technology experts that speak fluent nonprofit. At Cloud for Good, we translate your needs into technology, providing you with the best tools so you can work smarter and faster and do more good. How? Well, first we learn everything we can about your organization. Then, we create a design document based on everything we learned, along with our years of experience. Next, we customize your system and integrate it with your website or other databases, and migrate your existing data to the new system. Then, we train your team, and even provide ongoing support. We help you implement strategic solutions, so you can increase your fundraising, better manage your volunteers and events, measure your program outcomes, and do more good. Cloud for Good. It's all about your mission. Get your organization on the cloud today at cloudforgood.com.
Hi, everyone, and welcome, everyone. My name is Tal Frankfurt. I'm the founder and CEO of Cloud for Good. If you cannot see the screen, please put a message in the chat window so we can get a result for you as soon as possible. The webinar today is part of a series of webinars called Apps for Good. Cloud for Good is offering at no cost to the nonprofit community. You can find more information on our website under the Resources tab, and or you can keep up with us on Facebook and Twitter. Everyone is on mute today, so if you have any questions, please put them in the chat window and we will resolve it for you. We'll try to answer as soon as possible. Some volume issues. I hope that is resolved now. Okay, so today I have Jason from Cirrus Insight. Cirrus is probably one of my favorite applications on the App Exchange. You know, we use it at Cloud for Good probably every day. It probably saves me personally a few hours every day instead of going back and forth between my Gmail account and Salesforce. I can work from the place where I spend most of my day, in my Gmail. So I'm really excited to have Jason here with me. Before I give the stage to Jason, just a few words about Cloud for Good. So as you saw in the video that I hope you could hear, we work exclusively with nonprofit organizations and educational institutions to create and implement strategic solutions based on cloud technology. We work with variety types of organizations, from very, very small nonprofits organizations to very large institutions like Yale University and the Teach for America Alumni Organizations and Cornell Law School and Habitat for Humanities around the country, helping them to implement everything from tracking donors and volunteers to tracking dogs and cats and trees and houses. So I'm excited to have you all here today with me. And Jason, can you you ready to start?
Sure, absolutely. Let me share my screen here. Can everybody see me all right?
Yes, that looks great.
Good. All right, well, thanks for having us. That was a great introduction from Tal. My name is Jason Hubbard. I'm Vice President of Marketing for CirrusPath, and we make Cirrus Insight. So really excited to be here with you guys today, especially doing something like this with Cloud for Good. They've been an incredible partner for us. We're actually partners with us and working with us before we were even available on the App Exchange. So Tal and gang have literally been with us from the start. One thing we've been asking people to do during our webinar series and when we go to user groups and stuff like that is those of you that are socially proficient, we'd love that if you would tweet out some stuff while we're in here talking. At Cloud for Good is obviously Talon Gang, at Cirrus Insight is us. and apps for good being the hashtag. All right, so you know, quick little cartoon to you know make an introduction. You know, everybody knows CRM, Salesforce can be an incredibly powerful tool. It can you know, really transform how a business or a nonprofit really operates and works. But the problem with you know any CRM solution is user adoption is going to be key. Any CRM platform is only going to be as good as the data and information that you're getting in and out of it. And that becomes the crux of it. You know, how do you get people to adopt and use your CRM platform correctly? So, you know, two striking statistics whenever you look at CRM adoption. 65% of a fundraiser's or a salesperson's time is spent doing non-sales or fundraising related functions and tasks. And 74% of organizations have poor CRM adoption. Those are two striking statistics, and they're also two interrelated problems. So, you know, what are the problems? You know, this is a little meme that we like to have fun with here internally. Obviously, we're wed to CRM and Salesforce. We run our entire organization on it, but it also means that we feel the problems of, you know, CRM, you know, particularly acutely. So the problems with adoption, you know, really center around, you know, any CRM tool is at heart a database. So that means a lot of manual data entry, a lot of manually copying, pasting of stuff. And this becomes a huge interruption to your workflow. So you either have to take time out as you're doing stuff throughout the day to go in and update your CRM, or you have to set aside, you know, a couple of hours at the end of the day or the end of the week to update all of your records. So it's not an ideal workflow. So two solutions. You know, whenever we created Cirrus Insight, we saw the problem of usability within CRM tools, and we really wanted to fix it. You know, a solution that's been around for a long time on the Outlook side is the Salesforce connector for Outlook or LinkPoint 360. So there's been solutions around for integrating email on the the Microsoft side of the equation, but nothing's really been out there on the Google Apps side. So that's why we created Cirrus Insight. So we're the number one app for integrating Salesforce and Google Apps on the App Exchange. You know, one thing that we were pretty proud of was within a few months of launch, we rose to number one on Salesforce's App Exchange. That was back before they redesigned it, when it was really kind of a leaderboard. And our goal through all of this is to be as easy as possible. So we try and make CRM painless, have it be a seamless integration between you know where you live your day, which is primarily in your inbox, and Salesforce. So, you know, quick screenshot of what Cirrus Insight looks like in its current iteration. At the end, we'll go in and actually do an actual demo of the app, but, you know, brief snapshot of it. So your Gmail inbox that you know and love, Cirrus Insight resides off to the side and pulls, you know, your CRM, your Salesforce information into your inbox for you. Also the ability to create new tasks, new events, log calls. So key features, access of Salesforce information. So as you open an email, we're going to automatically look up that person's record in Salesforce based off of their email address and give you contextual information. So contact information, who is this person, give you a summary of you know your activity history with them, do they have open existing cases. So if you're you know trying to you know close around the fundraising and you see an existing case or existing issue, it may not be the time to try and do that. The ability to save emails into Salesforce with a click. So there's been BCC to Salesforce for Gmail users. Beyond being kind of a pain to have to remember to copy and paste that in every time, it's also not terribly specific. So we've got two options that I'll show you whenever it comes to saving into Salesforce. We've got a quick add that associates it to the account contact record, and that's just with the click of a button. But we also have an add to Salesforce, which allows you to relate that email to any object that you have within Salesforce. So any custom objects, anything that you may want to relate that email, we can do that. Sorry. Okay. Not a question for me. the ability to create new leads, contacts, and accounts from Gmail. So being able to create new records in Salesforce without even to leave your inbox. And a couple months ago, we released Calendar Sync. So it's a bidirectional sync. It syncs your events between your Google Calendar and Salesforce. So if you create an event in your Google Calendar, it's going to bring that over automatically to Salesforce and vice versa. If you create an event in Salesforce, it's going to bring it over into your Google Calendar. One of the really interesting things we discovered after we launched Calendar Sync, when we were building the app and building out Calendar Sync, one of the use cases that was a no-brainer to us was that you want to have those events associate with the people that attend that you've invited to that event. So whenever it's brought over to Salesforce, you want to maintain that association. So that's what we'll do. If you create an event, invite people in your Google Calendar, which most of us do because it's a better calendaring tool, we're going to automatically associate, look up and associate based off of those email addresses and associate that event with those corresponding records in Salesforce. Much to our surprise, after we launched, we're the only solution out there that does that. So kind of a no-brainer to us, but nobody else is doing it. A level of context and integration that you can't find anywhere else. Back to the theme of easy. We try and be easy in everything that we do. So we're not a managed package. We're a browser extension. Installing the app is literally a 20, 30-second process. So you download and install the extension, authenticate through Salesforce, and load Gmail, and we're up and going. So it's literally that simple to get in and start using us. We also have a 14-day free trial, painless to get in and give us a shot. For large enterprises, there's also the option to do automatic deployment through Chrome across your entire organization. So you can go in and install Cirrus Insight and have that pushed out to all of your users through Chrome. How does it work? A little rundown on the technology behind it. We're cloud in the truest sense, so we scale on demand. We onboarded a 1,000-seat organization last month and didn't even blink. Scales literally, as needed. So we're adding new features and functionality constantly. Those are pushed out automatically to our users. In most cases, you don't need to do anything. It'll just update automatically. At most, all you'll need to do is you'll be prompted to refresh Gmail, and those updates will be present. And some of the things that are specific that I had mentioned, we're the only solution that can save emails to any Salesforce record, and that automatically relates calendar events to contacts in Salesforce. So, on to the roadmap. At the end of this month, we'll be releasing what we lovingly refer to as V3, and I'll give you guys a sneak peek at that during the demo process. One of the really cool things about that is that includes support for custom fields and custom objects within Salesforce. So up till now, it's only been your standard fields and records. With this, you have access to all your custom fields and custom objects within that. You can even specify and design out what fields you want to appear and bring over from Salesforce through Cirrus Insight. So with V3, we already, with our current version of the app, have a lot of users that literally never go into Salesforce. Pretty much all of their functionality, everything is done through the app. With this new functionality, the ability to customize what your layout is and access to your custom fields and objects, we essentially become Salesforce's front end for you. So for most of our users, really the only reason why we would see them going into Salesforce is really to do either admin functionality, creating new fields and new objects, designing layout for the users, and running reports. But as far as the 90% of your day-to-day functionality and operation within Salesforce, that'll be done through our app. And then late summer, we'll release Contact Sync, so the second piece to the sync equation. We already currently have Calendar Sync, and we'll be releasing Contact Sync at the end of the summer. So, some of our customers, Grameen Foundation was one of our earliest customers. They've been a great partner for us. Change.org, we've been really fortunate to work with them, especially on the nonprofit sphere. Foursquare and Franklin Covey. Consulting partners, of course, Cloud for Good, have been with us from the start. Cloud Sherpas, Blue Wolf, we actually have 125 consulting partners, but these are three of our favorites. These are the guys that actually really go out there and do hard work for us. Pricing. So we offer a 50% discount for all nonprofits. So an annual subscription is $49.50 per user per year. Those of you that are, you know, joining us, you know, keep this in mind, Cloud for Good. So if you go to our sign-up page, there's a place for you to enter a promo code. If you use promo code Cloud for Good, that's going to automatically give you your nonprofit discount. So we'll follow up with you on that so that you can remember that one, but that'll give you your automatic nonprofit discount as well. All right, so you know, enough talking about it. Let's actually go into it and see it. So this is the current version of the app, the one that's currently out there and available. So if you went to our website and downloaded and installed it, this is what you would see. So as you open an email, you can see you know, the emails from Brandon. We'll automatically load that information, so give you your contact information. You know, we've got a couple of custom objects like licensed users that we're bringing over, but existing opportunities, activities, activity history. We use tickets instead of cases, but if we were using cases, that would be here. The ability to, you know, create a new task. Create a new event. And of course, if you create a new event through us, that's going into Salesforce and that's going to sync automatically into your Google Calendar. You can log a call. As far as creating new opportunities, because there's so much complexity around opportunities, at least in the current version, that's just going to load that in at Salesforce for you. The email functionality I was talking about, so if I wanted to save this email into Salesforce, I could hit Quick Add, and that's going to associate it with Brandon's contact record in Salesforce.
Hey, Jason, I have a quick question here.
Yep.
So, you know, nonprofits are using opportunities, but they rename it to donations, and then there are other some specific nonprofit starter pack features. How do you guys handle these?
So I'll show you here in V3, there'll be increasing exposure of those customizations that are specific to nonprofits. And then one of the exciting pieces is that the functionality and the customization that's built into the new version of the app that we'll be releasing makes it a lot easier for us to build out functionality around you know, custom configurations. And so one of the very first things that we're going to work on as soon as we've got the new version of the app out is automatic detection of nonprofit starter packs so that we'll bring over those custom configurations associated with that for nonprofits. So, you know, the short answer to it is we have varying levels of it, but within you know, the next few months, we'll have full integration with the nonprofit starter pack and the ability to bring over those ways that you guys are doing it that are distinct for nonprofits.
Great, thank you.
I was talking about emailing. So able to save emails into Salesforce a couple ways. You can hit Quick Add. Like I said, that's going to relate it to Brandon's contact record and account record at Salesforce. Or you can click Add to Salesforce, and that's going to bring up this screen, which allows you to choose how you want to relate. So you can relate it to any of these objects that are within there, but you can also go in and look at all of your custom objects that you've created within Salesforce and figure out how you want to relate it to that. We also give you the ability to save attachments in the Salesforce. That's both regular attachments and Google Drive attachments. So pick how you want to associate it. To Tal's question, when it comes to emails, even in the current version of the app, you've got access to all of your custom objects through here. Just not through the side panel. But when it comes to saving emails into Salesforce, we do have that fully integrated right now.
Yes, Plus Opportunities is actually donation, so it's really just a naming convention there.
Right.
The other thing, you know, just as an example, you know, you send a proposal to, you submit a grant to a foundation. It's an easy way to, instead of going to Salesforce and upload the grant or the LOI or the thank you letter, going back to Salesforce and uploading it, you can just do it directly from the email. So just one example of a use case.
Yep. Same story for being able to send a new email. So, you know, pop out the compose message. We have the Cirrus Insight icon here. Whenever you're ready to send it, you can click on that. You've got your two options. You can do the quick send or send an ad. That's going to give you the full options of figuring out where you want that to associate. So that gives you a quick rundown of the current version of the app.
go in and show you the new version. So the first thing that you're going to notice is it's a pretty radically different design. Instead of being a floating panel that resides on top of Gmail, we're fully embedded within it. You can see that we play nice with things like Reportive. So we just slide everything over. If you want to pop us out of the way, you can get us out of the way, expand us back out. One of the things we really like is, this ability to give you a quick snapshot of who this person is, so a summary of their contacts, record, activity history, so what your last activity was, what your next activity is. You can hover over it and or click on it and get those details of what all of that is. So what opportunities you have, open, closed, how much those have been worth, so you know how valuable this person is that you're talking to, existing cases, so open and closed there. Again, you can see what your next opportunity is, your newest cases. So you get a really great snapshot of who this is immediately whenever you open that email. It does show you, figuring out if you want to look up somebody's information who didn't get loaded automatically, if it's somebody in the email, you can just hover over that name, and it's going to look that up off of it, or you can go in and search. So Brian Huff's one of our co-founders. You can go in and look up their records and pull that up. So they don't have to be somebody that sent you the email. You can go in and pull anybody up in Salesforce. So you've got the level of detail of contact. One of the really cool things is the ability to do inline editing. Historically we've been able to create new contacts, new leads, new accounts. With the new version of the app, you can actually go in and edit all of those details without ever having to leave your inbox. As far as the customized layouts that I was talking about, you can go in and actually determine what you want to see, what's brought over from Salesforce. So you can literally customize. You can basically build out your own CRM platform, however you want it to look, however you want, whatever you want brought over within Gmail. So you begin to see what I was talking about. This basically becomes the front end for Salesforce for 90% of what you're ever going to do. Same thing for activities. You can still create new tasks, new events. Same story with being able to go in and edit those. Summaries of what events that you have. Opportunities. So you can create. So instead of clicking opportunity and it loading a new window in Salesforce, we're giving you the ability to do opportunities right within your inbox. So you can fully customize and build out all of that without ever having to leave it. And same story with cases. And then this is the cool part. So this is where your related lists are going to show up. So this is your custom objects. Things like Pat was talking about that are going to be specific for nonprofits. That's where you're going to see those and be able to access that in the new version of the app. So for us, the thing that we're a software company, the thing that makes our business work are licenses, so user licenses. So we can go in and look at existing licenses. If it's somebody new that we want to grant a license, we can create that license right here within Salesforce. So pretty much every organization has that thing that is crucial to how they do business that they run through Salesforce. And that's one of the primary reasons why people go into Salesforce is to be able to go in and access and edit those records. Well, with Cirrus Insight and the new version of it, you're able to go in and manage all of that right from your inbox. One little thing that's kind of cool is, Calendar Sync. Calendar Sync is literally as easy as just hitting authorize Gmail account. So whatever Gmail account that you're logged into at that time is the one that we're going to associate and sync to Salesforce. But all you have to do is literally just click that button and you're up and going. We do an hourly sync, so every hour we'll go and sync everything from both directions. And it goes 2 weeks back in history and 2 weeks forward. And one cool little thing, you know, a lot of you may be familiar with User Voice. We've been customers of theirs from the start, and our development pipeline comes entirely from our users. So we look at what is most in demand from our users, and that's what we decide to focus on as far as our next steps. With the current version, or with this version of the app that I'm showing you, we're answering 40% of what our customers have asked for through User Voice. So this is a huge release for us. But another really kind of cool thing with it is User Voice has chosen us to pilot their new version of the app. So if you want to go in and do product suggestions, User Voice is now embedded in there, so it'll give you, options on some of the most popular suggestions that are out there, and you can pick which ones that you want to add next, or you want to post your own idea. You can describe it here, and then User Voice will see if there's any corresponding requests within there. You can choose to vote on one of those, or you can submit your own idea. So again, just another level of integration that we're doing and trying to be, a customer-focused company and really doing everything that we do. So that's really one other little piece on it. So with the current version of the app, so version 2, we didn't have a presence in a pop-out window. With V3, if that's how that you like to use it in particular, so if you click on a email link in Salesforce, it's going to pop out a window like this. We did not have a presence in those pop-outs. We now do. So you've got all of our functionality right here along with it. So again, deeper integration, really fleshing everything out. So that's the demo. Do we have questions?
That was a really good demo, and that got me really excited about what's coming up.
Everybody tends to get pretty excited about it. We're pretty excited internally.
So what is your timeline for the new version?
We're shooting for the end of this month. So it's been in the pilot group for a little over a month, and we're closing in on hammering out the last final kinks and stuff like that, and already beginning to gear up some marketing around getting buzz and word out about the new version of this stuff. So you always hesitate to put a firm date on a release, but we're shooting to have it out before the end of June.
Okay, that sounds good. And guys, if you have any questions, please put them in the chat window. And while you're doing that, I'm going to, here we go. Well, we get a lot of positive feedback here
thank you guys. We love
from existing clients. I'm going to take over for a second. I'm going to share my, and then we're going to continue addressing questions. So I'm just going to give some people some time to just ask a little more questions. But while you're asking questions, I'm sharing my our website here. I just want to show you how you get to future webinars. Of the part of the cloud for Apps for Good webinars. It's if you go to resources under webinars, you'll be able to see lots of webinars. So our next webinar is a form assembly webinar. Then we have click and pledge. So Gmail, online donations, online forms, mail merges, fundraising, grant making, volunteer management, event management, governmental information. So really, whatever type of clients or constituents you're working with, you'll probably find a webinar that is relevant for you. So let's continue with addressing some of the questions. So Jason, I have a question here. Can attachments and emails only link to Salesforce attachments?
So attachments come over with the email in the activity history. Associated with if you do the click ad, it's going to be associated with the contact and account records. If you do the send an ad or the add to Salesforce options, then you can pick which options that you or which object Salesforce you want it associated with.
Plus, I believe you guys also upload it to Chatterfeed, right?
Yes. If you enable that ability within it, then it'll automatically get uploaded into the chatter feed as well.
Yeah, that's probably one of my favorite features because we use chatter pretty heavily. Another question here from Kathy: will we have option not to sync contacts if they wish to exclude that functionality? Is it possible to exclude it?
Yes. So it's going to operate in much the same way as the calendar sync functionality, except you'll actually have more granularity within it. With the calendar sync, it's pretty much a set it and forget it. So whenever you associate that Google account with that Salesforce account, pretty much everything that you do is going to get automatically synced over and updated. So first off, if you don't want to do that, then you don't enable that feature within Cirrus Insight. But the second piece within contact sync, we obviously have to build in a lot of rules and functionality because you don't want every contact record that you have in Salesforce brought over to your Google contacts and vice versa. A lot of people may have personal contacts in Google that you don't want brought over. So we'll have rules that you can set up and specify within Salesforce to be able to specify, for instance, leads that you own and be able to say that that's what you want brought over. So you'll be able to set up rules within it to say these are the contacts that I want brought over from Salesforce. And vice versa, in Google, you'll basically create a subfolder of contacts that are contacts you want to sync over into Salesforce.
Jason, just to make sure that I understand, so you can either exclude syncing of contacts at all, or you can actually basically pick and choose, right?
Right, exactly.
Okay. Then I have a question from Sarah here. Is the 49.5 per user per year, is this the nonprofit rate or the regular rate?
That's the nonprofit rate. So it's $99 a year for a for-profit company, $49.50 for nonprofits.
And a great question from Caroline here. Can you see the chatter feed in the sidebar in Gmail?
Not yet. So that's one of the, right behind contact sync, that's the next feature that we have that's in the development pipeline. So end of the summer, early fall, when we've got contact sync out and squared away, chatter integration will be the next place that we're going to.
Okay. And I have a question from Ed that I'm not sure that I understand, but Jason, maybe you do. Can I add Google Chat to contacts and associate to custom and standard objects?
Okay. I'm not sure, to be honest.
Okay.
Let me go in and look at my chats.
Oh, you want to add from the Google Chat.
Right.
Okay.
I know that Google keeps track of, so I'm assuming that wherever, and I'm trying to remember even where that is in Google. There it is, chats. Let's see. Let me go in and see if I can do this, actually.
By the way, we can't see your screen anymore.
Right. I was just pulling up. No, Google does not treat the chats like an email, so we can't bring those over like we would an email message.
Plus, I think they're going to change their chat in the very near future with the Hangouts.
If you want to enable that now, you can, and they'll be pushing that out as mandatory. So.
Great. It looks like, other than that, we have a lot of big thank yous for you guys. So it looks like we have some of your clients here on the call, and they seem like they're very excited about the calendar sync and a few other features. Guys, any last questions? We have more people saying they can't live without it. That's great. Cool. Well, Jason, I really appreciate it. I appreciate you guys jumping and, really helping us kick off this the Apps for Good webinars, and we look forward to continuing the partnership with you guys. And thank everyone for joining us.
Thank you guys so much.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you. Please stand by.